Hello everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back to another card making video. Today I'm making one of my favorite style of cards where I will be playing with critters and I'm starting with this cover die. This is a new die by my favorite things and it is called Beech Tree Forest Cover Up. It's one of those dies that if you love making scenes with critters, you will be using a lot. You can blend inks and use as your background. You can even use some watercolor washes, you can do some pattern paper. I'm going with solid colored cardstock. And I'm also going to die cut a snowbank that I can use for the bottom. This adds some extra layers on my card and makes it look more finished. I like using white glue for these steps since I can easily slide the pieces together until I'm happy with the placement. I'm also using my scissors to cut off any excess, and now at this stage I was going for a shaker card. And that's why I grabbed those very thin strips of foam tape so that I can go all around my panel. These are really handy to use and they are by Waffle Flower. I will leave a link down below. And of course I completely forgot to stick the acetate at the back and I'm going with the foam tape all around. The moment I realized it was already too late, so I just had to change plans with this card. That's why I'm just going to stick it on top of my background panel and I chose this lovely cool blue color. I think it's perfect for winter cards. I don't know the exact name or the brand, I just found it on my stash of cardstock. So anyway, now it's time to do some stamping. For that I'm using a new stamp set by My Favorite Things. It gives you three stacks of critters, I will go with one of them. And the stamp set is called No One Stacks Up To You. So I'm using my Misty to do the stamping and I'm using the Extreme Black ink by My Favorite Things. This is perfect if you plan to use alcohol markers to color your images. I'm going to stamp it a couple of times to get a good impression and then I will color everything by using my Spectrum Noir Triblend markers. These are my favorites just because I have all the three shades that I need in one barrel. I will do some basic and really quick coloring and then now I'm going to use the matching dies to cut out that stack of critters. And here is a reminder, don't forget to like this video, it really makes a difference, as well as hit the notification button if you haven't done so already, so that you get notified whenever I post a new video. Now you can play with the critters and your tree background, you can have them popping from behind or you can stick them directly on top, which is what I'm going for with this card. If it was just one critter, I think I would go with it popping from behind the tree, it would make it look even more fun. I did use the connected alphabet to cut out the whole alphabet, I'm going to use only a few of the letters and I will keep the extras on an envelope for a future project. I'm also adding an extra snowbank at the top. This is going to add an extra layer and make it look even more dimensional. Now I'm going for Let It Snow and I want to have the letters in white. However, since it is white over white, it doesn't show as much. That's why I cut out the alphabet one more time from the blue cardstock, which is the same color as my background, and then I'm going to lay one letter on top of the other, giving it a little bit of a shadow. I'm just offsetting the two letters slightly. Using white glue makes this step really easy since you can slide those two letters until you're happy with the placement. Now in the Itty Bitty Holiday stamp set there is one sentiment that says Let It Snow. I'm going to use only the part that says Let It and I'm going to stamp it over my letters. And by the way, this little Itty Bitty Holiday stamp set is one of those that I have been using since I got it again and again. It comes with so many sentiments and a very small font which fits pretty much every card. And of course you cannot have a card for winter and snow without actually having snow on your background. And since that idea of having shaker snow at the background failed completely since I forgot to use the acetate, I'm going with my white Nouveau Drops and I'm going to add my own snow. I'm making sure that not all those dots are the same size. I have some smaller, some bigger, just to make it look more interesting. And to tell you the truth, at the end of the day, I think I love this card as it is. I wouldn't change anything. And maybe it was a happy accident that I forgot to add that acetate to turn it into a shaker card. So that was the card for today. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. Down below in the description area, you will find links to all the products that I used to create this card. I hope you'll all have a lovely day, and I'll see you all next time.